This is 3.6, number 21. We have f of 4 minus g of 4. What's the most common mistake kids make when they evaluate functions like that? F of 4. What's the first thing they tell you in the book? It's not what?
Multiplication.
It's not multiplication. It's not 4f, exactly. Sometimes you're cruising along and you just do that without thinking, but it's not 4f. And I think it tells you what f of x is. F of x is negative 3x plus 4. And g of x is negative x squared plus 4x plus 1. So to evaluate this, we have to evaluate each one of them separately. So f of 4, where are we plugging in 4? 4x. So it's going to be negative 3. I like putting parentheses when I do these substitutions. And I end up with negative 12 plus 4 is negative what? Negative what? 8. Got it. Okay. What about g of 4? Where am I plugging in 4? 4x. You can speak loudly, guys. I need to be able to hear you from this distance. So what's the most common mistake at this point when I plug in 4 for x? What do you think the most common mistake is at this point? Yeah.
I'm plugging into that.
This. I mean this right here. Yep.
That you would...
Yeah, what do you think the most common mistake there is?
Square,
yeah. Yeah. Is the negative being squared?
No.
The negative is not being squared. X is being squared. That is the opposite of x squared.
But so, in this certain situation, one did not like that. It's negative 4 squared.
No, it matters a great deal. Let me show you. So you're plugging in 4 right here. That is how you plug it in. 4 times 4 plus 1. So let's do it the proper way, and then I'll show you the improper way. So in that case, what is negative 4 squared?
16.
No, it's not.
Negative,
negative 16. It's the opposite. This negative is not being squared. It's not being squared. So this is negative 16 plus 16 plus 1. What does that come out to be?
I thought you meant like if it was in the
parentheses. If it was in the parentheses. Oh, I'm sorry. I said it wrong. I'm sorry. I understand. Negative times x squared. I'll do a delay there. That's better. So what does that equal? What's negative 16 plus 16 plus 1? 1. So now we know that f of 4 plus g of 4 is equal to negative 8 plus 1, which is negative 7. So the most common mistake I would see, everybody, the most common mistake is instead of writing negative 16 here, what would they write? 16. So it would be 16 plus 16 plus 1 is not 1. What is that? 33. So just be careful. Guys, can you just not talk well? I'm right next to you. Thank you. When you plug in, is this square affecting the negative sign? Is it? Is this square squaring the negative sign? It is not. It is only squaring the x. If, let's say I wrote this, I'm going to come up with a new function. Let's go j of x is equal to negative x squared plus 4x plus 1. Is that an entirely different function? What's the difference? Yes, look at the difference. Look, is this the same as that right there? Are those two the same?
Yes.
Are they? Really?
Really? What's the square doing? It's affecting the
x. Oh, yeah.
So are this, is this and this, are they the same? No, they're not. In this case, you're squaring the negative 2. So this is always going to be positive. Plug in 4 right there. What's negative 4 times negative 4? Positive 16, right? Correct. Yeah, go ahead.
Hold on. Let's finish this one first. Now, what is j of 1 going to be? Negative 1 squared plus 4 times 1 plus 1. That's 1 plus 4 plus 1 is what? 6. But what's j of negative 1 going to be? Negative 1 squared plus 4 times negative 1 plus 1. What's negative 1 squared? 1. So you end up with 1 minus 4 plus 1. What's that equal to? 1 minus 4 is negative 3 plus, negative 3 plus 1 is? Totally different answers, depending on what you plug into which function. Okay, so yeah, look at this. It was, you see the negative sign I just copied wrong? Take a look. There's a negative sign right there. So what should that be? That should be minus. So instead of negative 7, what is it? Negative 9. Yeah, good catch. Yeah, good catch. The question is asking, you're supposed to find f of 2.
f of 2 on this thing? When it says find f of 2, that means when you plug in 2 for x, what is y? So 2 is approximately right, let's say it's right here. So if you go over to 2 on the x, what do you now do? If you go over to 2x on the x-axis, where do you go now? Down, exactly. You want to go down on the function to here and find out what's the y value. You want to find out what that y value is. And if you look at this graph, it looks like it goes down to negative 3. So what's f of 2? What is the y value when x is 2? Based on what I just drew there. Negative 3.
Is the y equals x
important? Yeah, it's just telling you that that is the function y equals f of x. They're just labeling this. They're calling this function y equals f of x. They're just calling it. They didn't give you the actual equation. They're just calling it y equals f of x. They're calling it that. So then, for example, then the next one would be f of negative 1. So where do you go on the x-axis to start that one? If it's asking for f of negative 1, you go to negative 1 over here, right? And then you go up or down. You go up to here, and you find out what the y value is. And if you get the picture, I didn't draw it exactly, but it's at 2. So what's f of negative 1?
2.
There it is. Here's a side question for you. Let's say I said f of x was equal to, say, I would say negative 4. If I said f of x equals negative 4 and asked you what x is equal to, what would you go to first? You go to what value on the y-axis? You go to negative 4 on the y-axis and figure out what the x value is. So if you look at this picture, negative 4, it comes out to about 2.5. Looks like it's 2.5. Alex, yes, you have a question, or was that? It says graph the linear function. What type? What is that going to look like if you have g of x equals negative 4? Alex.
Isn't it a horizontal line?
Nope. Oh, yeah, sorry. What am I? You got it, and I am totally wrong there. Totally wrong there. Man. So where's the horizontal line?
Negative 4.
So we'll call that negative 4. And then what can we draw right there? Hey, horizontal line. You're absolutely right. Good job. And instead, yeah, it's y equals negative 4. Good. And then it says give the domain. What's the domain of this function? Someone else. Nick, what do you think the domain is? It is. Correct.
Why it's is it all
because what part of the x-axis does it cover? What x values are you allowed to plug into that function? What x values are you allowed to plug into the function? All of them. Is there any dividing by? There's no division. There's no square. You can plug any x value you want. Look at the shadow that function makes on the x-axis. Is there any part of the x-axis it misses? No. Here's a slightly harder question. What's the range? Can someone tell me what the range of this function is? What's the range, Mar?
-4 infinity.
Look at it sideways. What's the only part of the y-axis it covers? Just negative 4. The range of that function is just negative 4. Because what's the definition of range? The set of all output values. What's the only output? No matter what you plug in for x, it's always output is negative 4. So what's the range? Negative 4. Let's say it was a vertical line at x equals negative 4. Let's say it was a vertical line at x equals negative 4. What would the domain be?
Just negative 4.
Just negative 4. What would the range be? All real numbers. Yeah, exactly. Vertical lines always have a range of all real numbers. Horizontal lines always have vertical lines always have a range of all real numbers. Horizontal lines always have a range of one number. Just remember, what's the definition of range? It's the set of all output.
Yeah.
Domain is the set of all input. Just always go back to those key statements. Yes, Harrison, I'll give you another one. Let's do something curvy. Let's say I gave you this right here. Let's do a fun one. Let's do another axis there. Need two. So let's say I gave you, what color do we like? I like that pink color. And I'll draw in some y values here. Let's say that's 4 and that's 2. And that's negative 3 right there. Can someone tell me what they think the domain of this function is? Based on that picture, based on a reasonable analysis of that picture, what do you think the domain is? What part of the x-axis does it cover? Someone who hasn't spoken yet, raise their hand. Someone who hasn't spoken yet. Obs. What part of the x-axis does that cover?
It covers the origin.
I'll ask it differently. Are there any parts of the x-axis it doesn't cover?
Yeah.
Which, really? The shadow.
No, it doesn't.
So what's the domain?
All real numbers.
Correct. The domain for this one is all real numbers. How wide does this thing go? If you shone a light from the top and bottom, what shadow would you see on the x-axis? The entire x-axis would be covered. These arrows, are these arrows going straight up? No, they're steep, right? Can a function ever go straight up?
No.
Because then it would be just a
relation.
Correct. So assuming this keeps on getting wider, how much of the x-axis does it cover? All of it.
If it goes horizontally, is it going to be a function?
Yes. Yeah. Horizontal line is one. Absolutely, because it has different outputs for different inputs. Yeah. Well, it's the same output for different inputs. What about the range here? Can someone tell me what the range of this thing is? The range. Nick. -3 is one point out of an infinite number of points. That is an important point on the range. That's a very important point. Harrison. Yep. Comma what? Yeah, because does it ever, it goes up. What's the lowest? So does it matter that it doubles back right here? No. What's the lowest y value? -3. What's the highest one? Oh, it keeps going. What's the shadow? If you looked at it sideways, what would you see if you looked at it this way? What would you see? You'd see from -3 up. You'd see from -3 up. Exactly. Solving for y.
Yeah.
What do you think the first thing we should do is, Milo? There are many first steps. What do you think we should do first if we were going to isolate y?
Subtract 2x.
From?
It's -2.
It's -2x, thank you. So, change your answer, Milo.
Add 2x to both sides.
Perfect. So if we add 2x to both sides of this equation, we add 2x. It's interesting, when I asked that question, Milo, what do you do to both sides? What do you think some students say? Instead of saying a complete sentence, add 2x to both sides, sometimes they'll just say what?
Add 2x.
Or even less. Do you know how frequently I'll get 2x? Can I buy a verb, you know? You have to do something, right? So what do you end up with? 5y is equal to 2x plus 9. And then Shane, what should I do to both sides now if I'm going to... And when you divide both sides, you have to divide everything. Everything. So y is going to be equal to 2/5 x plus 9/5. Have you noticed that I like to put parentheses around things?
Yeah.
Why do I like to put parentheses around things? It's pretty clear. If you drop parentheses or start writing your fractions sideways, what can happen? It gets floppy and sometimes really hard to follow. Like, is that x in the numerator or is it in the denominator? Here, outside the parentheses means it definitely has to be in the numerator. Okay, so that's part A. Now, replace y with function notation. So what's the only change we need to make once we've isolated y? Alex?
Just replace y with f of x.
Exactly. So you have f of x. And y, what's the point? Do you remember what the point of using function notation was? There were a few points. Could you have more than one function in a problem?
Yes.
Could you have three? Could you have four? Are there real life situations where there are going to be lots and lots of functions involved? Yes. What would happen if you used y equals something 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 x for each of 10 functions and you tried to work with all 10 of them? Yeah. So what do you need? You need to name the functions. What's the name of this function right here?
F.
Could it be any other thing you want?
Yeah.
Could it be Bob?
You said that in your...
I did say that in the video. It literally could. And you will see named functions. Sometimes you start running out of letters in the English alphabet. You get to really fun math classes when that happens. You know what you use when you run out... What the common thing is you use when you run out of letters in the English alphabet?
Like Greek...
Yeah. You start using alpha, beta. And not only do you use lowercase Greek letters, what else do you use? Uppercase Greek letters. So when you take more math, you get to learn a lot of Greek. Do you know in a lot of math graduate programs, you have to know multiple languages? Because of things like this, and also you have to be able to read math documentation in other languages. Yeah. Whoa, I just made you think math is cooler, didn't I?
You